Volvo's Care Cab has an ergonomically well-designed and functional placement of levers, controls, and buttons. In this section, we're going to look at the location of the most important buttons and controls. Refer to the operator's manual for a more detailed description of all functions and operating controls. Just in front of the operator's field of vision is the front instrument panel. Using the display and keyboard, the machine provides the operator with all important information when operating. On the front panel, you'll also find switches for the parking brake and hazard flashers. Up to the right is the climate control panel, the button for cab ventilation, and one for the cab's heating timer. Below, you'll find buttons for the air conditioning, the fan control, and the temperature control, as well as the air distribution control with recirculation and defroster. Air is brought into the cab through several individually adjustable ventilation nozzles. They're positioned both at the front and rear for optimal performance. The most common buttons on the A-post are these. You control the grapple functions with the high-lift servo control. Down raises the grapple arm, up lowers the grapple arm, right opens the grapple, and left closes it. This switch controls the tilt. Push it left to tilt backwards, and push it right to tilt forwards. Here is where you control the tilt of the grapple. Left tilts it back, and right tilts it forward. The switch on the left locks the grip. You can rotate the grapple clockwise by pressing the top on this switch and counterclockwise by pressing the bottom part of the switch. Activate the carry position by pressing this button. On the right side, you'll find kick down, raise push bar, lower push bar, and the engine brake. On the floor, the accelerator pedal is located to the right. The accelerator pedal has a built-in mechanical resistance, which together with a throttle indicator in the display, informs you that you are working in eco mode. As the pedal is pressed further down, the machine enters the power range. Next to the accelerator pedal, in the following order, is a brake pedal, the differential lock switch, and a second brake pedal. The fire suppression system is recommended for machines operating in fire hazardous conditions. The sprinkler system is semi-automatic and protects the engine compartment and beneath the cab. When the parking brake is released, the sprinkler system goes into manual mode. As the name suggests, once the system is in manual mode, you must activate the system manually in the case of fire. If fire is detected during machine operation, an alarm is triggered using the siren and/or strobe light, and a red light appears on the control panel. The system should be activated manually using the emergency stop, which also kills the engine and cuts off electrical power. The release button beneath the transparent hatch allows you to engage the system while you're driving the machine to a safe spot. When the ignition is off and the parking brake applied, the fire suppression system is fully automatic.